happens like this for most of us. You can be going along, living your life, and then suddenly you open your eyes and you realize you've dug yourself into a deep, deep hole. You don't know it at the time, but you need a second chance, more than anything else. That's where I was. And then, out of nowhere, a second chance appeared. It happened like this.
Nicely done, musician. A few more tries and we've got it. Angela, I told you last week that the end sharpened your solo. Honestly, your siblings would have never...
Jared, how many times do I have to tell you? Cymbal mallets are for hitting cymbals only.
This is stupid. I totally hate violin.
Ooh, Angela broke her violin.
Detention.
It happened like this.
Heather, this just isn't like you. You've always been such a smart, nice girl. It seems like you and Leslie were getting along so well. What happened?
I don't.
Why would you say those things, Heather?
Regardless, spreading vicious rumors is strictly against the school code of conduct. That's going to mean detention.
And so was the day I sold my soul for a do-over.
You did not sell your soul for anything.
And this is how it happened.
Hey, what's your name, kid?
Raymond Bundy.
Will Raymond Bundy? That would be a detention.
Kidneys on the black market.
Ew, gross, Kevin.
Also, you better not fall for any bad boy heartthrobs in detention. My friend Miko said they're actually mutant aliens whose only purpose is to obliterate the human race. It's probably best away from me, darling.
In your dreams, Kevin.
Angela, what are your parents gonna do when they hear you broke your violin?
Take a chill pill, Wendy. It's not that big of a deal.
It's not that big of a deal. I can probably read the whole time I'm in detention. I might even get to finish the crucible, my friends.
You should also finish your chem homework. Did you figure out question 19? It took me nearly half an hour to realize they were talking about iodine. And when I got it, it was totally sweet. Not chemistry.
Yeah, whatever. Nobody wants to hear about your chemistry problems, Paul.
Jeez, Heather, you have to be such a jerk.
Well, maybe you guys should try talking about something other than chemistry for a change. Anyways,
gotta go.
I go, Jamie. I'm gonna be late.
Since when have you cared about being on time? Side note, how'd you know I wanted the Butterfinger right now? I never knew I had such a sweet little brother.
In your dreams, you troglodyte.
Thanks. So, how's the last week in Minnesota treating you?
Well, they expel me from foster care, and if all goes well, they'll expel me from this school before I even leave.
Ugh, losers.
I couldn't care less about this school anyway. Well, gotta go. See you for my detention, the usual place. Princess, how'd a pretty little face like you land itself in detention?
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Miss Morton, and I am the detention supervisor. The rules are as follows. No talking, no eating, no running, no reading. No sneezing and no leaving. Sit and contemplate the wrongdoing of your ways. May the next 2 hours leave you as changed individuals. Detention begins now.
Does that mean no breathing either?
Watch your tone, young man. You'll be here longer than today.
Sorry I'm late, Mrs. Morton.
You'd be Tracy then. You can make up your time at the end.
I knew it would be a long 2 hours when my ex-best friend, Tracy, walked in. It hadn't occurred to me that after nearly a year of successfully avoiding each other, we'd end up in that revolting place together. I knew it would be a long 2 hours. I didn't belong with these kinds of people. That was Raymond Bundy, voted by the school's most likely to end up behind bars. At this rate, I'd probably end up just like him.
It sure was going to be a long 2 hours. At least I would say goodbye to this stupid school soon.
This is ridiculous.
Kids, it's going to be a long 2 hours.
We had no idea
how much we needed a second chance.
What are you kids doing here? There's no detention today.
Where'd everyone go?
Home, I'd assume? Anyways, time to go. We gotta lock up.
Everything felt like I was in a dream. I just had to get home, grab some money, and clear my head over some Donkey Kong at Molly's Malts. Then it'd all be okay. So good thing my six musical siblings, Alice, Adam, Abigail, Andrew, April, and Alex, were waiting for me when I showed up.
Angela's home.
Oh, our sister Angie is home.
Darling, come here and let your grandma Sally give you a kiss. Mwah. Your siblings are putting on a concert. You better go join them.
Hi.
Angela.
How?
Was.
Your.
Did.
Question mark.
It was okay. We had a test in science.
Otherwise, it was.
Angela, you should play your violin with us.
Yeah, it'd be super, super fun.
Sorry, guys, but my violin is actually broke. I was just about to head over to Molly's Vaults to meet up with some friends. Maybe another time?
Yeah. Okay. Gross.
That's okay.
Besides, we're better anyways.
Totally.
Yeah.
Exclamation point.
Hey, Richard. I hear it's about time for April's 9th birthday party. What do you say we do something special?
How about we talk about this after April is out of earshot?
What?
I said, how about we talk about this after April is out of earshot?
What?
I'm just pulling your legs on.
April, are you just going to take that? Grandma and Dad forgot you're already 9. I guess it's hard having 7 kids in the family after all.
Nuh-uh, I'm turning 9. 9, 9, 9, 9, 9.
It's not. 1988? I feel sick.
Come here, honey. Well, it feels fine, but you don't look yourself. yourself. I'm going to say no to the arcade, so just go up to bed and get some extra rest.
Yeah, okay. Good night, everyone!
Good night, Angela!
Kissy face!
I didn't know what to do, I didn't know what to think. Now, I don't seem like the smartest type, but I figured that the only thing that could explain what's going on here was time travel.
Maybe something paranormal is going on. Or I'm going crazy. I know, I'm dreaming. I've just got to wake up. Wake up, wake up, wake up! What are they calling me right now? Hello?
Hey, if nothing lasts forever, will you be my nothing?
Kevin, it's good to hear your voice right now.
How'd you know it was me?
You can't start a conversation without a pickup line, so I kind of figured.
So, I was just calling to let you know just how thankful I am for your friendship, and I also need help with question number 5 on our math homework.
I don't know, 8 pi maybe, but Kevin, listen, can you tell Stacy and everybody that I won't be able to make it to Molly's Malt? We were just going over to Molly's, right?
No, I'm pretty sure Molly's has been closed for like 6 months.
Huh, that's weird, no Molly's. Hey, Kevin, this is going to sound crazy, but hear me out.
I'll have to think about it.
Kevin!
Okay, just kidding, what's up?
So I am completely confused why everyone keeps saying it's 1988. Because just 1 hour ago, I was 100% sure it was 1989. So, I think I just time traveled.
Didn't April hit you on the head with her bass drum mallet again?
I'm fine, Kevin. If you're my true friend, you would believe me.
Well, I'm not sure why this is a good idea, but I believe you. What are our best friends for, after all?
Promise you believe me?
Promise.
Anyways, here's what happened. Just about an hour ago, I was in detention with a few other kids when all of a sudden this janitor! That's it! The lights, the creepy words! There must be magic or something! Oh, Kevin, thank you so much! I think I figured out what's going on! I could just kiss you right now! But we can talk later, or in like a year. Wait, I don't know. Anyways, gotta go!
Good night, Angela. Do I still get that kiss?
Had mostly worn off by the time I got home, but slowly I began to realize something still wasn't right.
Mom, Dad, I'm home! Wait, what's this doing here?
I had broken that vase a year ago when I accidentally knocked over a sky-high pile of hardcover books. Had Mom found a replacement? It was almost like, but it couldn't be, could it?
No, it couldn't be. 1988? It says 1988!
My vision started to grow black around the edges.
I've gotta sit down.
So, was I like Ebenezer Scrooge, pulled from his real life and stuck in his past? But it couldn't be. I felt trapped.
Heather, you're home. Sorry, Mom. I didn't see you one question, though.
What year is it exactly?
1988. Did you hit your head or are you playing a prank on us?
Yep, I'm totally playing a prank on you.
I think you should go lay down on the couch, darling.
Dad, I'm fine. I'm always fine. Finer than Elizabeth Bennet after she falls in love with Mr. Darcy. Totally fine.
Heather, couch.
Fine.
Now, just relax. I'll wake you up when Tracy gets here.
What? Mom, OMG, Tracy, like Tracy Johnson? She's coming over?
Did you forget about that too?
Yeah?
Honey, I told you this morning.
Tracy and I weren't friends anymore, but I figured if it was 1988, maybe we still were. But why would I want to be friends with her again? All she ever did was whine about her parents' divorce. This day could hardly get any worse.
Dracula? You should know that my blood is so full of Cocoa Puffs it's actually toxic to vampires. Tracy, what are you doing here?
Sorry, did I scare you? Your mom said I should wake you up.
Well, what I wanted was to wake up from this stupid dream, but you obviously couldn't do that. But you know what? It's fine. Whatever.
Well, Mom and Dad were fighting over who gets that stupid lamp again. I totally need something to get my mind off of it. What do you want to do? Shoot some hoops?
Gross. Sports. Shoot me.
Just kidding. Want to watch a movie?
We could watch The Breakfast Club. Story of my life right now.
I'm in.
Tracy, can I tell you something? It's going to sound like a psycho, but just hear me out.
Sure. You can tell me anything.
So, have you ever had the feeling that you somehow got stuck in your past, like exactly a year in the past, and everything's wrong the way it used to be? We're not even supposed to be friends anymore. All you want to do is wake up and make everything go back, except you have absolutely no idea how to go back. Do you know what I mean?
Girls, can I get you anything? Hot cocoa, Kool-Aid, snacks. We have popcorn.
I could hardly be in a worse mood for Kool-Aid right now. Thanks, but no thanks.
Thanks for the offering, Mr. Marvel. I'm fine. No, I don't really know what you mean. Can I tell you something, too?
Sure,
I told you about my parents' divorce, right?
Yeah, obviously.
Well, it's just that I can't imagine what life would be like, you know, without all of us living together. Nothing's ever going to be the same again.
Tracy, take a chill pill. If they weren't meant to be, they weren't meant to be. It's not that big of a deal.
You don't understand.
You're going through. I know. You've told me hundreds of times.
Why can't you ever just listen to me? You know what? I have a thing. I'm supposed to be home for dinner. Meatloaf.
Tracy, wait.
Don't go. And then I realized I blew it. I had no idea what power had left me here, but I didn't realize until just that moment that I had been given a second chance. A second chance with Tracy, that is. And then, being the brilliant Heather that I am, I went and blew it.
Thought I would rip a hole in time. Turns out, time is just like silk. I was waiting for Jamie in our usual spot when I saw the newspaper. I was looking at an ad for a bolt cutter when I saw it. Bush elected. How was that possible? Bush was elected last year. The paper must be old, plus it was a dumb newspaper anyways. Once they said a robot attacked a police station.
Bush? Whoop, ow! My leg. My everything.
Raymond! You look like you were beat up by a shovel. Did you not sleep last night? Again?
Shh! I feel great. A little too great.
Ray, I've been your foster sister for 6 years now. We're practically real siblings. I know something's up. Let's take you home. It's starting to rain.
Yeah, no thanks. I don't want to go back to that stupid house anyways. They don't want me. I'm just a mess up. I'll probably get expelled from the foster system before I even make it into high school.
Did the foster care guy decide that Mr. Responsible Goody Two-Shoes Raymond Bundy was too perfect for their system? Where are you going could go? Washington, D.C.? The White House?
Hello, Brainless. Are you listening? You listening in there? You sure? Alright, cool. Or send me to the streets. Well, to Iowa, at least. Next week.
You're joking, right?
And then I put two and two together. I had no idea why or how, but somehow I seemed to have been transported back in time. Exactly a year in the past.
Yeah, gotcha. Yeah, let's go home.
The next day, it took me about 2 minutes to realize that nothing had changed. I was still trapped in time. That meant I had to stick with my plan, and that plan started the minute I got to school.
So, who's up to helping me with something?
Well, that depends. What is it?
Oh, it's nothing. It's just, I kind of need you guys to cover for me in economics when I sneak into the detention room.
Whoa. Why do you need to sneak into the detention room?
Look, I know this is going to sound crazy, but yesterday when I was in detention, I accidentally transported back in time.
What?
I know it sounds impossible, but I'm telling the truth. The detention room is basically a time machine, so I just need to go back there, and then I'll teleport to my regular time, which is for you guys a year in the future. You don't believe me, do you?
Angela, you know we love you, but...
No, we don't believe you.
You sound insane, Angela.
You know what? Forget I said anything!
What's her damage?
I have a joke.
Okay?
What do you call an angel that's adorable?
I don't know.
An acute angel.
I went to school the next day. I didn't know what else to do.
Tracy, come on, at least look at me, please.
I can't take it anymore. Seriously, get over yourself.
I need to get over myself. Loving, doting parents. I can't believe how spoiled you are.
Well, at least I don't talk about myself 24/7.
So you're saying I should shut up about whatever's on my mind? Well, you should know that when your parents get a divorce, it doesn't feel like a bruise on the knee. It feels like your whole world is crashing down around you. But what are friends for if you can't fake happy all the time?
Whatever.
You know what, Heather? I'm done with you.
Class, please take your seats. Now for attendance. Adams?
Here.
It seemed like the ultimate betrayal. Suddenly, I saw the day Tracy and I met flash before my eyes. It was in second grade. I was brand new to Franklin Elementary, and I had no friends. I spent a whole week of recess reading Nancy Drew on the sidewalk by myself. But then, there was Tracy.
Hi, I'm Tracy.
Hi, I'm Heather.
Tracy had spent that whole week alone, too. I just hadn't looked up from my book long enough to notice. She loved sports, but all the other girls wanted to do was play swings or braid hair. The boys had rejected her, too. Apparently, soccer wasn't a girl's sport. And besides, she probably had cooties, they say.
So, do you want to be friends?
Sure. Do you like Nancy Drew?
Not really.
Do you like soccer?
I could teach you a cool trick.
You can teach me a trick for a lesson.
From that day on, we spent practically every minute together. The thing was, we had absolutely nothing in common. We shouldn't have become friends, but that's maybe what made it so special. But now, I didn't even know what to think.
Adamowski?
Here.
Adler?
Hiya.
Anderson? Bowler?
She's sick.
Thank you, Kevin.
No problem whatsoever.
This was going to be it. I was going to go back into the transporter room and then everything would go back to normal.
Please let me go back! Please let me go back!
Better get back to class,
to your mother, and before that it was Grandma Sally's.
That was until my evil little brother bit my finger off.
But Dad, I don't even like to play the violin.
Ooh.
Angela, honey, listen. We know you're just saying that. Everyone goes through a phase where music feels more frustrating than rewarding. I did too when I was in eighth grade. I completely fell apart at my piano recital. I was playing Beethoven's Empezzato Sonata, and my fingers got all tangled up. I started crying right then on there on stage. I know it's tough now, but I know you'll get over it sooner or later, and you'll be so glad you did.
Yeah, okay, I'll
do
better.
Smart, and you should be proud of it. Heck, your family should be proud of it. The world should be proud of it.
Thanks, Kev.
Also, I've been waiting for you to tell me. It's no secret you love gaming way more than violin, and I think you'd make a great video game designer. You should just talk to your dad, okay?
Okay.
If you understand.
Yeah, okay, Kev.
Also, I have an idea, but I need you to cover for me an econ event tomorrow. After that, I will never skip class again.
Better have a good reason.
I promise.
Okay, no problem. But actually, I need help with question number 6 before I go. Is that okay?
Sure.
We'll be right back.
It wasn't until that night that I realized what day it was. In some cruel twist of fate, the time gods had decided to make me relive the worst night of my life.
McKay, Walter has his stuff.
Hey, those are mine. Stop it.
This is a Walkman. How did nobody foster to get one of these? Probably nicked it.
Give it back.
Ever since Walter had come to stay with us about a month ago, the tormenting had gotten worse and worse. I knew what was going to happen next. I knew I had to get out of here, or it would happen exactly as before.
It's a picture of you and Mommy, and it's new. She must not love you enough to keep you around. I know it sounds bad, but I'm glad mine's dead. It's better than being unwanted.
Give it back!
Where are you going, huh? I didn't see somehow mirror while you weren't watching.
No, I just forgot. I thought, never mind.
I froze. I don't know why.
What, are you gonna cry now?
Walter, stop!
What are you gonna do, huh?
Walter, quit it! I am bigger, stronger, faster, and smarter. You do not want this.
Come on then, you're so tough.
Walter, I don't want to fight you.
Oh my God, what just happened? Raymond, I'll talk to you in the kitchen.
My name is Trudy White. I'm a foster parent in Will County. I'm calling to report an incident that occurred today between two of my foster children.
Job of not drawing attention to myself when, all of a sudden, I finally found her.
Mrs. Janitor!
Oh, hey there, Angela. What can I do for you?
Please, miss, I need you to send me back to normal time.
No, can't do that.
Why not?
Not every day a young lady like yourself gets a second chance. I'd make the most of it if I were you.
But, wait, I have no idea what you mean.
Sooner or later, usually... Dad, you usually lose yourself. You can't do much of anything.
Stay true to myself. Yeah, go on.
Sooner or later, you'll look back and realize there's not much you left to you. Usually, it's too late to do much of anything.
Second chance to be true to what matters. But wait, before you go, why me?
Why you? Why anyone? Well, I guess it's pretty easy to spot when someone feels like faking their own skin. I'm a little magical, so I figure I'd help you three kids out.
Wait, so you mean those other two kids that were in detention are here, trapped in time with me?
I guess you can put it that way.
I have to find them and tell them what you told me. Then I promise I will find a way to set things right.
I have no doubt you will.
Thank you, and goodbye!
Bye, little miss. Oh, and always remember to recycle. What, I'm still a janitor.
Hello, Raymond. I'm Miss Noll, the school social worker. I don't think we've met.
Here, have a seat.
I had no idea what I was doing there, but I was pretty sure that Mrs. Noel, the social worker, was a social and more ruining your day.
So, how's it going?
Fine.
Okay, Raymond, I called you in here to talk about how things are going at home. How are you and your new foster brother, Walter, getting along?
Not well, I guess.
Okay, the school got a call from the county sheriff's office this morning. They said you hit Walter last night. So I'm taking your science to mean it's true? Well, Raymond, you're 13 years old and strong. Walter is just 9, and you could have really hurt him. He's hurt and scared. He deserves a home where he can feel safe. What's going on? Okay, well, if you're gonna say nothing, here's what's gonna happen. I'm working on the paperwork to send you to a different foster home. Somewhere without any of the siblings. Logistics for this kind of thing always take a while, so I say still about a year here. So I need you to be on your best behavior around Walter. If this kind of thing happens again, I'm guessing Walter's case for a girl press charges.
So you'll just believe whatever they tell you?
I'm just doing my job, Raymond. I'm sorry, I truly am.
Whatever, I'm out of here.
I wasn't quite sure why I hadn't spoken up. What I did know is that Walter didn't deserve this either. Us foster kids can have messed up lives when we're not used to people cutting us a break.
Hey, you! There you are! We've got to talk!
Fine!
I wasn't too terribly sure what to do, but I was starting to finally hatch a plan.
Why did you even bring me here?
Okay, so, hi guys, my name is Angela, and raise your hand if something weird is going on. I thought so. So, you know that weird janitor gal? I think she might have transported us back in time.
It was her?
Are you sure it didn't just hit your head?
How rude. Anyways, the janitor said that we were starting to become a person that we're not. She said that at some point in our lives, we were straying away from who we really are. So, in our current lives, it was too late to change much of anything. But where we're at now, I guess we've got a chance. That's why we're here.
Every one of us is dreaming. Boy, do I sure hope that's true. Well, that didn't work.
Anyways, I have no idea what to change. Maybe I just need to think harder. Also, I never actually learned your guys' names.
Hi, I'm Amundra.
She meant in English, stupid.
I'm Heather, by the way.
Well, I can tell you're all very delightful to be here, but I have some undefined excuse to leave, so see ya.
Wait, you can't just leave. We have a problem to solve. Who knows? We could be stuck here for an eternity if we don't do anything.
Yeah, I would agree with you, but then we'd both be wrong. And I have neither the time nor the cranks to explain this to you, so I don't need your help.
Raven, get back here! We have to figure out what your problem is!
You're my problem!
Shoot, I should probably go too. I'm sure I can figure out my problem, whatever it is.
Well, fine. We can talk later if you get stuck. Wait, I think I figured it out. I just need to be true to myself!
That's when I realized it was high time for me to get out of there because my problem was waiting for me at home.
Right, Richard? Angela, it breaks my heart that you don't want to continue with something I love so much, but thank you for being honest.
One more thing. I don't just spend all that time at the arcade for nothing. I want to learn how to make games, the math and science of it. So, if it'd be okay, I was wondering if I could join an after-school computer club.
I think that can be arranged.
Thank you. Wait, why didn't I go back to my regular time?
And that is when I realized that the other kids must have to fix their problems too before everything would go back.
Should I go? If you say that you are mine, I'll be here till the end of time. So you've got to let me know. Should I stay or should I go? It's always tease, tease, tease. You're happy when I'm on my knees.
As soon as I left, I immediately realized what I needed to do. The problems all started when Tracy's parents got the grand idea into their heads that they should split up.
OMG! I think I just had a totally radical idea! I could get Tracy's parents back together, just like in the Parent Trap! Gosh, how do I come up with such good ideas? Tracy, I just had a great idea and I think you're going to love it. Mr. Johnson, Mrs. Johnson, it's Heather and me to talk to you.
Hi, Heather, what's going on?
What do you want, kid? I need to get back to moving.
So, Mr. Johnson, Mrs. Johnson, I was thinking, you two should like totally kiss and make up. Yay, one big happy family.
Excuse me? Heather, are you serious right now?
Tracy, I'm trying to get your parents back together. That way you won't be sad anymore.
That's cute, kid. We already made our decision.
Mommy, Mommy, Mommy!
Here, Tommy.
Candy!
Go back to the house. We'll talk about it later. Heather, honey, when two people get divorced, they can be sad at first, but sometimes it makes everyone happier in the long run.
Yeah, our family isn't going to be the same, but that's not a bad thing. We still love Tracy just as much. Know that, right, Tracy?
You don't get it! You have to get back together!
Stop! That's not the problem anymore! You're my problem! All I need is a supportive friend and you made me feel even worse!
Tracy! Tracy! I've got to go!
Wait! Wait! Here's a good one. Are you a bank loan? Because you've got my interest.
Heather, your pickup lines get cheesier every time. So, what we've got to do is help Heather solve her problem, or else I can't go back. Got it? Heather, there you are. We've been looking all over for you. This is Kevin, by the way.
Hiya. So, did you solve your problem yet? Are you okay?
I don't know. Well, you've got to tell us about it, or we'll be stuck here. And I, for one, do not want to relive seventh grade.
I guess I just tried to get my friend Tracy's parents back together, and that didn't go well. Tracy started shouting. Don't know why. I guess she was just mad that I always got so annoyed whenever she talked about her parents' divorce. But it was so annoying. Plus, it's not like I could do anything about it.
Oh, that makes sense.
What makes sense?
So, Heather, I know everyone thinks I'm a princess and my life is all peaches and cream, but it isn't. And sometimes I just need to vent, so I talk to this weirdo. And I don't know why, but I start to feel better. Do you think that's how Tracy is?
Yeah, maybe. I think think I just messed up big time. She probably thought I didn't care about being her friend unless she was happy all the time, which isn't true. Tracy was the best friend I could have ever hoped for. And when I had a second chance, I went and blew it. Too late now.
Too late now? It can never be too late. You got this.
Well, there's nothing I can do.
I have a question. Did you ever, apologize to her? You know, say I'm sorry?
Sorry? I guess not, but I can't do that. She probably thinks I'm the biggest loser in the world by now.
You can because you have to. The longer you wait, the harder it's gonna get. Are you in?
If you really think it'll work, I'm in.
I'm in too. Let's bounce.
So, they're moving you two to foster home?
Yeah, but who cares?
Well, I care.
Well, fat difference that makes.
Where are they taking you?
Papers haven't gotten through yet. It sounds like I'm here for another year, maybe. It sounds like they're sending me to Iowa or someplace like that.
Well, just remember, whatever happens, I'm in your corner. I'll even bury that dead guy you murdered.
That wouldn't help my case.
Why did you just get up and leave? Walter's an idiot. Why'd you let him get to you?
It's not that simple.
It is that simple. Look, I love you. You're my baby brother. But I have to know why you just didn't run.
Look, what did you want me to do? Walter was threatening Michaela. It looked like he was gonna hurt her.
Okay, now that sounds more like Raymond. I know. You wouldn't do anything to hurt anyone. You may be a know-it-all snob, but when it comes down to the wire, your heart is good.
If you say that again, I will end you!
Say what you will, do what you will.
I just don't know what to do.
Well, just remember, you can't always be a tough guy. Did you ever consider telling the truth? Do you think they'd believe you?
Well, I think they'd have to. I caught on tape, after all.
Are you an idiot? You have the entire thing on tape and you're sitting here whining about it?
Look, what do you want me to do? This tape will get Walter into just as much trouble as I am. The kid's messed up, but he acts that way for a reason.
I'm guessing I stand no chance of convincing you to change your mind.
Nope, no chance.
I'm going to miss you, baby brother.
I don't want to go. Just became happy again.
I know.
Actually, I have some homework. Yeah, I can always apologize later. Heather? You can do this. I'll be right here.
So will I. Plus, I can do this.
Heather! If there's anyone worth fighting for, it's Tracy.
Okay, I get it. You can stop lecturing me.
Tracy, I'm sorry. I finally realized what a dweeb I was being. All you needed was a good friend who could really listen. I guess I just didn't get that into the big nerd brain of mine, so I give you my sincerest apology for real this time.
Wow, you finally listened to what I was saying. Thank you.
Actually, I'm such a genius, aren't I?
Sure, Heather, whatever helps you sleep at night.
Tracy, dinner!
I better go. This is gonna be the last meal we'll have together as a family.
Totally. I get it. See ya.
Definitely.
You did it! Now let's go find Raymond!
I'll just be over there.
Listen, Raymond,
We're here because both Angela and I solved our pasts, but we can't go back yet. We're all stuck here until you do something.
I didn't do it, but being the good person I am, I'll clean it up.
Thanks for destroying the one thing I've had since I was three. And no, I'm no superhero, so let me get back to my flat pillow. I was dreaming of steak when you woke me up. Steak, woman!
Raymond, be nice to these girls.
Why, thank you.
And him, I guess.
No, stop. Jerk.
Raymond, you have to tell us what your problem is.
How? I don't commit breaking and entering and expect to yell buddy-buddy after that.
Oh, I can help. The social workforces that be are moving Raymond to a different foster home.
So I guess we're just sharing all our secrets now, huh?
Dude, let her talk.
Fine. I pushed the bully. Blah, 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 blah. No one believes me.
Ahem. Wink, wink. Nudge, nudge.
Oh, except for her, I guess. But that doesn't even matter. I ain't no rat. For once, this is why I egg houses.
Wait. You egg houses?
Wait a minute. You don't? Man, I've seen hairballs more hardcore.
Raymond, is there anything we could do to prove that you're innocent?
Nope. Nothing. Nothing at all. Ow! Fine. I caught on tape. Pretty much the whole thing. Also, will people stop punching me in the arm? My arm is so swollen I can barely take off my shirt.
Raymond, this is perfect. All we have to do is play this to an adult, and then you'll be innocent to prove that you're innocent.
Whoa. Hold your horses. Like I said, I ain't no rat, and I couldn't do that to Walter. This is a good place to live. He needs it more than I do.
Raymond, since when has this brat been up? Been listening the whole time is my guess.
I think you should do it. Some of them too.
Walter, I'm not going to snitch on you. You know that, right?
Well, I think you should. I was a jerk to Michaela, but that's just how everybody was to me at my old home. But she didn't deserve it. Neither do you.
You're right about that.
I'm gonna tell him anyways, even if we don't.
Wait, really? Really?
Mom, Raymond did nothing wrong. He was just trying to stop me from hurting Michaela. Don't make him go, Walter. Here, put this with the tape.
On
the counter for mom to see. Are you going to? There! I did it! Happy?
Good job, Raymond. I'm proud of you.
Not to be a buzzkill, but isn't something supposed to happen? Creepy lights, flashing sounds, etc.
Maybe one of us didn't do something right?
Are you telling me I fessed up for nothing?
Nah, it wasn't for nothing. They won't make you change foster homes anymore, probably.
I think you're right, sis.
No, that drew my mistake.
Sorry to interrupt, but I'm real sleepy all of a sudden. Mind if I just lay here?
I know this is a weird time, but Angela, I was wondering if maybe you'd want to go to Molly's monkey sometime.
Sure, Kevin. Good night, Kevin.
Wow, this totally won't backfire.
Shut up, or I'll give you a shiner.
Thank you.
Ah, was I gagged by a spoon?
Well, see you, folks. Wait, Miss Janitor, does this mean... Well, you're back now, if that's what you mean.
Oh, hi, Heather. I didn't see you there. That's kind of weird. So, my place, right?
Your place?
Yeah, my dad. He wanted to see if I could recite Macbeth from memory, and you'd help me with my batting. Plus, Paula, Leslie, and Julia are coming over after dinner.
So, we're friends again?
Yeah, why wouldn't
No reason.
Then let's go already.
I bet I can recite the whole first act before we even get back to your house. When shall we three meet again? Thunder, lightning, or in rain?
Angela, are you a time traveler? Because I see you in my future.
You have no idea how bright you are, Kevin.
You're telling me I've been looking all over for you. What are you doing here? But seriously, I'm just here to walk here to your computer club meeting, and then I've got to skedaddle, as they say.
Computer club? I'm in computer club?
Yeah, I think I'd forget the only thing you ever talk about. Apparently, it's part of your grand, magnificent dream of becoming the creator of Donkey Kong 2.0. But look, I know your pride is broken, but I've got our Saturday plan. It's gonna be perfect and totally romantic. First, we're going to break into the Oval Office and kidnap the president. Then we're going to narrowly escape arrest by taking off in a spaceship. And then the three of us are gonna chill in the universe-famous jacuzzis on Jupiter. You ready? Well, if you object, I heard they're playing Back to the Future at the theater. And then we could go get Rocky Road ice cream and maybe hold hands. Wait, no, it was good.
Yeah, that sounds okay.
Miss Morton, why can't I find my name on this list?
I don't know, that's the official list.
Wait, when did you guys get here? Call me crazy, but I swear you weren't here 5 minutes ago. I must have fallen asleep.
Raymond, where were you?
In detention.
What were you doing in there? Did they finally figure out that Straight A Raymond is actually Rebel Inside?
Yeah, I guess so.
You'll never guess what. Brad's got tickets to the Twins game next week, and he can't go. So, have a little bit of Cracker Jacks and take me out to the ball game. Sound to you?
Next week? But I'll be in Iowa next week.
Try to act a little bit more thrilled, why don't you?
Wait. I'm not going to Iowa next week?
No.
Well, Twins game sounds great then. I'm in.
So, Heather?
Yeah, Angela?
Raymond? I was wondering if maybe you guys wanted to head over to Molly's Vaults tomorrow. Tracy and Jamie can come.
Sure, Warren.
I'm typically allergic to all semi-liquid beverages made of high-fat dairy products.
Ow, fine. I'll be there.
But wait, before we go, Mrs. Janitor.
And that's the story of the one day we walked into after-school detention.
As a princess.
As a brain.
And as a harmless civilian. Ow, fine. As a criminal.
But somehow, all it took was one afternoon in the torture room. I mean the detention room, to figure out what we needed to do.
Dream our own dream.
Hang on to our friends.
And speak up. I mean, like, really yell. And people listen. Or be dead.
Quit it, Raymond. You mess up all of your lines.
Fine. Speak up. Get heard.
That day, we walked on a little closer to being the people we wanted to be. The people we knew we were, deep down. So we just wanted to say something to you, Miss Janitor. You spend your days roaming these halls, often unnoticed, cleaning up the messes we make, but you noticed us and cared and gave us a second chance. So what we wanted to say was...
Thank you!
Angela, Heather, and Raymond, you're welcome. And kids, I'd like to leave you with some departing words.
Always remember to recycle!
Time every night, falling and crying, so I get out of bed, put on my
The show's over.
Go home.
It's done.
And remember, last one on the way out shuts off the lights. I'm looking at you.
We're saving electricity.